Dear viewers, in this video, we are going to see the negotiable instruments in India with special focus to bill of exchange. Before going into the video, subscribe eLearning at Ease for videos on education, scholarship and employment. Section 13 of the Negotiable Instruments Act highlighted three documents: promissory note, bill of exchange and check. I have already posted a video on promissory note. I will give the link in the description. You can see that video through that link. We will focus on bill of exchange now. First, we will see the definition of bill of exchange. According to Section 5 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, a bill of exchange is an instrument in writing containing an unconditional order signed by the maker directing a certain person to pay a certain sum of money only to or to the order of a certain person or to the bearer of the instrument. You can have more clarity in the definition of bill of exchange through its features. First, it must be a document in writing or in the printed form. It must contain an unconditional order to pay, that is, one person will order another person to make payment of money to a particular person or bearer. So it must be signed by the person who draws, that is, the person who is giving order. Drawee means the person who is accepting to pay. The name of the drawer, drawee, and payee must be clearly mentioned. The amount payable, it must be an order for making payment of money only. The amount payable must be clearly mentioned in the order, that is, in the document. The date of payment, the stamp, everything must be affixed in the document. Now we will see the parties to a bill of exchange. First person is drawer. He is the person who is giving order to a particular person called drawee for making payment to a particular person called payee. So drawer makes the document. He is giving order to the drawee to pay money to payee. So these three people are primary people. Now the document will be handed over to the payee. The payee can endorse the document to another person. Okay, so if he transfers the document to another person, the payee becomes endorser. So now the person to whom the document is transferred from the payee is called endorsee. So the payee becomes endorser and the person to whom the document is transferred becomes endorsee. Bearer. So sometimes instead of mentioning the name of the payee, the drawer can mention the bearer of the document. Okay, instead of mentioning the name of the payee, the drawer must prepare the document as pay a certain amount to the bearer of the document. Like that, the drawer can prepare bill of exchange. At that time, the drawee has to pay money to the bearer of bill of exchange. So bearer is the person who is holding the document at a particular time. So these six people are the parties to a bill of exchange. This is a specimen of a bill of exchange. You can see at the top right corner of this document, the place and date is clearly mentioned. The revenue stamp is affixed. The rupee symbol is there. I already told you, we were discussed that only in Indian currency the amount should be mentioned. Rupee 1,50,000 is clearly mentioned. 3 months after date, pay Mr. R. Here Mr. R is the payee or his order. If Mr. R endorses the amount to some other person, endorses the bill of exchange to some other person, the drawee has to pay to the particular person. That is the order of Mr. R, a sum of rupees 1,50,000 value received. Here to Mrs. Q, she is the drawee, Mr. P is the drawer. So Mr. P is preparing this document. He is giving order to Mrs. Q. She is drawee. Mr. P is drawer. Mrs. Q is drawee. So what is the order? P is giving order to pay 1,50,000 to Mr. R. So this is the bill of exchange. It is an unconditional order given by Mr. P to Mrs. Q for paying rupees 1,50,000 to Mr. R or his order. So Mrs. Q has to sign this document as accepted, like this, accepted. She has to put her signature here. Name and date of acceptance should be mentioned here. So this is a typical specimen of bill of exchange. Now we will discuss the types of bill of exchange. There are two types of bill of exchange. The first one is trade bill and accommodation bill. Now we will see what is a trade bill. Here the seller of a particular product will prepare the bill of exchange and it will be accepted by the buyer of the product. So here the seller becomes the drawer, the buyer becomes the drawee. The seller can write his name as payee or he can write some other person, his creditor or some other person here. So any bill of exchange which is drawn for a sales transaction is called trade bill. Now we will see the meaning of accommodation bill. This bill is being prepared and accepted to give mutual help to one another. For example, if I am in the need of financial support, I need to give back money to my seller. So I will ask my friends or my creditors to pay certain amount to the seller. So that kind of a bill to help a financial support or to provide a financial support to a particular person, especially to the drawer, it is called accommodation bill. Thank you so much for your patient listening. If you are happy with the video, give a like. You can ask your doubts through the comment section. Share this video with your friends and subscribe eLearning at Ease for more videos.